Thank you. Thank you very much for the kind introduction and invitation to give here this presentation. So, in everyday life, we encounter objects where you cannot properly look through. Take, for example, this piece of paper. I have written something on the back side, but you guys only see the front side, and you don't see what I've written here on the back side. Of course, sometimes it's possible to turn the object around, but that's what we consider cheating. And this is not always possible. Here at the University of Twente, we have developed a technique to basically determine what is written here on the back side by just only looking at the front side where you guys are sitting. And this technique is not only valid for this piece of paper, but also for the sugar cube that you see here on the background of the slide, but also for teeth, for paint, and for egg. And what all these materials have in common, that is when light arrives in the material, it encounters all tiny little objects. These tiny little objects cause the light to reflect in random directions. It's like light travels in a random mirror maze. This is what we call in physics scattering. And this is exactly the reason why these kinds of objects appear white. And it's also exactly the reason why you can't look behind or inside such a scattering material. The same is also true, for example, for tissue or human skin. For example, in this slide over here, you see the hand of my supervisor. He holds his hand in front of a light bulb. Clearly, light can travel through the hand. However, you don't see any inner details in here. You don't see the bones. Actually, we still have to rely on, for example, X-ray imaging to really determine what is inside the hand in this case. That's something that we don't want. We have developed techniques here that should allow us to get the same kind of details like X-ray imaging, but then just using optics. And like any kind of optical experiment, you first start with a laser. This laser is incident on your material, and the light travels through the material, and it undergoes all these kind of random walks. It gets redistributed. And if you would hold a screen behind your random material, you don't see a clear laser spot like you now see here on my shirt. No, if you would hold a screen at the backside, you will see all kinds of intensity fluctuations. That is what we call a speckle pattern. No clear laser spot anymore. All the light is scrambled up, to put it that way. Now, what we do is we control how the laser light arrives at the scattering material. The laser light travels through a device called a spatial light modulator. That's very similar to an LCD grid that is used, for example, to project this presentation here on this screen. What basically happens, the laser light is divided in segments, let's call them pixels. And for each pixel, we can control the delay at what moment the laser light arrives at our scattering material. And in this manner, we can basically control how light travels through such a scattering material. It's basically like a navigation system for light. And in this way, we can also make sure that behind the scattering material, you get an enhanced speckle spot. And this is what you see here in the bottom right of this presentation. You see in the center a clear laser spot visible. These pictures are taken for laser traveling through a layer of white paint. And you see clearly in the middle your laser getting back. In this case, we have used this layer of white paint more or less as an optical lens. And I actually would like to show this experiment also for real. For that, I have a demonstration experiment with me. So I hope that one of the camera people can join me over here to project everything here on the screen. I see shaking heads. That's unfortunately not possible. So in that case, I would like to... there's the cameraman. Yeah, good. So what you see over here, please, could you join me here from this side? Yeah. What you see over here is a similar optical setup like we use. And here is our sample where we shine laser light on. So if you could hold it a bit closer, yes, you see it. I mean, it's very similar to this. It's a piece of glass which has a rough surface. You can't look through it. It's basically the same type of glass that is used in your bathroom window. Now, we shoot at it with green laser light. And on the back side, we project everything here on this card. So if you can hold it a bit closer, please come a bit forward. Don't be shy. Yeah. You see a spot blinking on and off, if you look very carefully. This spot is such an enhanced speckle. I try to make it a bit more visible. Yeah. Now you see it going on and off. That is really the laser light that travels through our scattering material. Now, this is actually all I would like to show for the moment of this demo setup. Please join me during the lunch break or at a later moment to discuss this setup in more detail. But the point I want to make is we can basically, by controlling the incident wavefront, we can focus light or get it through our otherwise opaque material. And by using similar techniques like this, so can we please return to the presentation? Yeah, thank you. By using similar techniques like this, we can also have a look what is behind our scattering material. So I hope this... I think there is a malfunction with the... Well, I'm clicking... Yeah, great. So, okay. We want to look behind the scattering material. What is hidden behind there? So that's basically this experiment that I promised before. So what we do is we have a white object. For example, this white wall. And we place behind there our object. Our object has the property that it's fluorescent. What that means that if this object is hit by light, it starts to emit light in a different color. That is what is fluorescence. Now, suppose there's an observer standing in front of this white wall. It won't be able to see the object. However, the observer knows his optics. The observer is allowed to use a laser and shoot at the wall. Now, the laser light gets scattered by the object, and then behind the object, again, a speckle pattern appears. And this speckle pattern also illuminates the object. But because the object is now hit by light, it will also start to emit light. This light is in a different color and can weakly leak through the white wall, and that can be observed by the observer. However, it is way too weak to really tell what is now the object behind the wall. And the observer, unfortunately, also doesn't know how does this speckle pattern look like? Too many unknowns, the observer just simply still doesn't know what is going on. However, the observer can do one thing. He can basically control at which angle the laser beam is incident on your scattering material. He can basically change the angle of incidence, and in that manner, the speckle pattern remains the same, but is just translated over the object. And the observer can still look at the total intensity as a function of the incident laser light in here. And in this manner, the observer can obtain more information about what happens behind the white wall. And in this manner, he can actually reconstruct what would have been the original object. And that's exactly what we have pioneered here at the University of Twente. We have hidden a object behind a piece of ground glass, so that is this, basically this bathroom window. You have to trust me that you can't look through it. But then we shoot at it with laser light, and we measure just how much fluorescent light do we get out of it, and then we change the angle of incidence of the laser light and repeat that. From that we get more information, and then we are able to really reconstruct what is hidden behind this glass window. On the left, real object, right, the reconstructed object. And with this wonderful result, I hope I have explained to you that we are now really able to look through otherwise opaque materials. That's it. Thank you very much.